after watching Blake Masters just clean up the stage with Mark Kelly there, I can see why Katie Hobbs does not want to debate Kari Lake. She joins us now via Skype. Good to see you, and thank you so much for joining me. I have to tell you, I'm looking at the latest polls. You're surging ahead. You're doing very well. I can understand why your opponent would decline a debate. She wouldn't last.
Yeah, well, she's got a lot of baggage in her past when you look at her voting record. I mean, some of the crazy stuff she was voting for. And when you look at how ineffective and incompetent she's been as a Secretary of State, when you look at the fact that she's a twice convicted racist and the people of Arizona are paying out nearly $3 million in settlement fees because she paid women of color tens of thousands of dollars less than she paid men in her office. I mean, she's a walking nightmare. And we did a forum, Dana, this week, and she agreed to show up, but she required that they make me park a block away from her, enter through a separate building entrance, put curtains up so she couldn't see me. And then she went on stage, and it was a meltdown. They asked her softball questions, and she couldn't even articulate answers to the softball questions. This will be coming out tomorrow, and I think people are going to be shocked. They're going to understand why she doesn't want to debate. You know, that's how she answers questions. And she wants to represent and be an ambassador for Arizona. The embarrassment she would be on a national stage would make us the laughingstock of this country.
Yeah. And her extreme positions as well. I saw we're talking with Kari Lake, who obviously now is in the lead, Republican candidate for governor in Arizona. Because this, and I don't want to stay on this topic forever because I know that's what Democrats want. Everybody's concerned about the economy, gas, energy. But on the issue of abortion, I know you were talking, and I know what you meant to say, because you talk to so many people, and you're one of those rare candidates that has phenomenal media training. I mean, for crying out loud, you were an anchor, so you know all of this, and you were highlighting the Democrat long repeated phrase of, well, abortion should be safe, legal, and rare, but now they're all the time taxpayer funded, you know, whenever we want without limitations,
right.
And you were talking about this. And you were saying, and I know what you meant to say. You were saying rare but safe. You were really parroting what they parrot all the time. But I think what you also did, and I wanted to get your thoughts on this, you ultimately made them own up to how far left they have gone on this issue, because the majority of Americans do not agree with the Katie Hobbses and all of these other, you know, the folks who were supporting legislation that wanted to repeal the Hyde Amendment and wanted to remove limitations on abortions up until the moment of birth. I mean, that was actual legislation that's been sponsored Democrats were supporting. Talk to me a little bit about this, because that's extreme. That's not where America is, but that's where people like your opponent and Democrats are today.
Yeah, and their mouthpieces in the media try to make people who are pro-life look extreme. Look, I want to save as many lives as I can. I want to help women. I want to make sure they truly get health care and get support that they need when they are pregnant and about to deliver. And they want to make that sound extreme, when what's really extreme is how far this pro-abortion movement has gone, where they truly are for abortion right up until 9 months in the womb and days after. They're okay with infanticide. I'm not exaggerating. They're okay with infanticide. And they're calling us extreme for wanting to save babies. They never ask the questions of the Democrats. And they want taxpayer money to fund that. You know, my opponent actually voted when they was faced with some legislation to give life-saving medical treatment to a baby who would to survive an abortion. She voted no, choosing rather to have that baby die on a cold metal tray. So I'm just trying to expose where they stand. I think that is extreme. And they have turned this from what they first were saying, which was safe but rare, to right up until birth, after birth, and we will just outright kill a baby who survives an abortion. It's barbaric, it's obscene, and they need to be called out for it.
Yeah.
I'm running for governor. I don't write the laws, and I think you understand that, Dana, and so do your listeners. I execute the laws, and we abide by them, and right now, our governor says it's a 15-week ban, but it's caught up in the courts, and we'll be finding out where it is. But what I want to do is help women who are afraid, make sure they truly get health care, and save as many lives as possible.
There you go. Kari Lake, who's the Republican candidate for governor in Arizona and is leading in the polls. You were also talking about the touching on the federal involvement in the state's business. One of your predecessors, Jim Brewer, got into one heck of a battle with Obama, Biden over immigration, trying to just execute the laws as they have been written and passed as it pertains to the border, which is, by for all intents and purposes, is entirely wide open. That is a huge job, and I know that you're ready for that fight, but talk about how difficult it is and how hard it is for lawmakers to, I mean, because this, you have every right as a border state to protect your citizens, but the federal government is essentially demanding that you carry out a federal, their federal policy with your manpower, your taxpayer dollars. That seems like that's like a violation of 10th Amendment. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, we're going to go to the U.S. Constitution for the solution. Obviously, the Guarantee Clause, Article 4, Section 4, says that the government protects us from invasion, but they're not doing that. As a matter of fact, they're part and parcel. In my opinion, Joe Biden is working with the cartels because he's allowing this to happen. And the cartels have operational control, and we have an invasion at our border. And so we're going to invoke our Article 1, Section 10 rights, basically. Authority to protect our own border. Three criteria need to be met. One, we have an invasion. Yes, we do. And yes, in fact, we do. Two, our people are in imminent danger. And three, there's no time for delay. We meet all three of those criteria. We're going to invoke that authority, and we are going to take care of our border on our own. Shouldn't have to be this way, but we've got to do it. We can't be the state where fentanyl is the pipeline pouring in and killing a young generation. I just had the most difficult conversation, Dana, with three parents yesterday who lost sons to fentanyl poisoning. This is a weapon of mass destruction, and we need to start treating it that way. When you lose a child, never get that child back. You never get to realize those great moments and milestones with your child as they grow and get those first jobs. They get married, they have children. These parents will forever have that hole. And unfortunately, more than 100,000 people have been lost due to this scourge. And we're going to stop it here in Arizona. Mm.
And Arizona voters are responding. As we were saying, Kari Lake is leading in the polls, Republican candidate for governor of Arizona. And you have Trump's backing. You have all the right people's support for this, which is angering the folks in the media. Very much. They want to talk about you. They don't want to talk about inflation. They don't want to talk about taxation. They don't want to talk about ESG. That's another thing that I find interesting. The environmental social governance. It's the green grift. A number of states, they're trying to move so that they can protect their constituents from all of these ESG standards. It seems like the behavioral credit scoring system for China. How do you, as a governor, protect your businesses from being penalized by this grift, your constituency from being penalized this grift? What powers do you have at your disposal as governor?
Well, I mean, I don't want to rule by executive order, but there's always that. And we could put out an executive order that says any business that is pushing this ESG, this social scoring, we don't give contracts. We don't give state contracts to them. This is outrageous what they're pushing on us. They're coming at us at every angle, trying to turn us into a communist country. And we're just not going to have it in Arizona. We are Wild West Arizona. We're uniquely Wild West, and we're not going to take it anymore. And we'll push back in any way possible. I believe we're going to have a red wave, and we'll have a great legislature to work with to prevent some of this woke garbage from permeating and seeping in to Arizona politics. We'll do what we have to do, but we will protect Arizona from that.
I hope that when and if your opponent decides to have a debate with you, I'd like to be in the front row, because that's that's going to be interesting. Kari Lake, Republican candidate for governor of Arizona. We're going to watch this because I think this is one of the more interesting gubernatorial races, I think,
it's
in the country.
It's the most important one. It really is.
Very much so.
I'm not saying that because I'm in the race. I'm saying it because if we lose one more border state to a leftist, we will have a wide open border, the cartels will be in control, and I think we lose our country. We're at ground zero for all of the key issues here in Arizona, and my opponent is the most radical leftist politician to ever run for statewide office.
That is an important point, what you just said, because the governor and the legislature, those border states, you guys, in absence of any kind of federal accountability, You guys are the last gatekeepers there. So that's incredibly important. It's kind of like our the whole country's gubernatorial race in Arizona. We're all kind of watching it.
I believe it is. And that's why so much interest is we're seeing it from other states, and we're seeing people donate money, and they're like, you've got to win. You've got to be the line of defense at that border or we will lose our country.
Kari Lake, Republican candidate for governor of Arizona. We love talking with you. We'd love to have you back. Thank you so much for your
time. Anytime. Thank you, Dana.
Take care.